in order to become truly proficient with scikit-learn, you need to be able to read the documentation. In this lesson, I'm going to walk through the five main pages and page types that you need to be familiar with. The first page is the API reference, which you can get to by clicking on API from the top navigation bar. The API reference gives you a high-level view of everything available in scikit-learn. Namely, it lists all of the classes and functions organized by module. For example, this is the Compose module. There's a brief description of the module, a link to the relevant section of the user guide, and descriptions of the two classes and two functions contained in the module. If we wanted to learn more about Column Transformer, we could click on it and be taken to the class documentation. The class documentation is the second type of page you need to be familiar with. It gives you a detailed view of a class, in this case the Column Transformer class. At the top is the class signature, which lists the parameters and their default values. Starting in version 0.23, everything after the asterisk needs to be passed as a keyword argument, also known as a named argument, rather than by position. There's also a link to the source code for the class. Next is the class description, a link to the relevant section of the user guide, and sometimes the version in which the class was introduced. Next, you'll see the same parameters from the class signature, except here it provides a detailed description of each parameter and the expected data type. Below the parameters are the attributes. As a reminder, attributes will end with an underscore if they are learned or estimated from the data during the fit step. Next are links to any related functions or classes, any important notes, and some simple usage examples. The next big section is a list of the methods. It starts with a description of each method, and below that you can see the parameters and return values for each method. Again, you can click on Source to view the source code for any method. Finally, there are links to examples that use this class. Let's click back to the top of the page, and then click over to the user guide for Column Transformer. The user guide is the third type of page you need to be familiar with, and you'll know you're in the user guide when you see the numbered sections. The user guide is more like a tutorial because it explains why you might want to use a particular class and advice for how to use that class properly. It often discusses related functions and classes and includes additional usage examples. Let's go back to the class documentation for Column Transformer. Click to the bottom and click on an example. Examples are the fourth type of page you need to be familiar with. Examples vary in structure and length, but their distinguishing feature is that they demonstrate how to solve a particular problem from start to finish. You'll always see imports at the top, and buttons at the bottom to run the example online or download the example to your computer. Let's go back to the class documentation for Column Transformer one more time. Click up to the top, then scroll to Parameters. Sometimes in the documentation, you'll see highlighted terms that are not classes or functions, such as fit and transform in this case. If you click on it, you'll be taken to the glossary, which is the fifth page you need to be familiar with. The glossary defines almost all of the important terms used in the scikit-learn documentation. If you just want to browse through it, you can access it through the More menu in the top navigation bar. Let me now summarize the five pages and page types we walked through and describe how I use them. The first page is the API reference. I go here when I want to see what classes or functions are in a particular module. For example, if I wanted to review all of the classes and functions that are available for pre-processing, the API reference is the fastest way to do this. The second page type is the class documentation. I go here anytime I need to understand a particular class in depth, especially all of its parameters and attributes. The third page type is the user guide. I go here when I need more context about a particular class or function, or advice about how to use it properly. The fourth page type is examples. I go here when I need to see a more complex usage example of a particular class, since the examples in the class documentation and user guide are purposefully simple. The fifth page is the glossary. I go here when I need to understand a particular term and it's not covered in the user guide. If you're ever unsure where to start, you can click on User Guide in the top navigation bar and just start browsing the section that seems most relevant, or you can do a search in the search box.